Friends. All right. As I start this, I just realized I have to share my music with you. All right. There we go. Now we're rocking and rolling. Welcome to August. Welcome to day one. Grab some water and join me. We're going to start standing, warming up lower body. So I need 1 foot under your hips, knee soft, and we are starting with hip flexor openers. So I'm starting us standing right away, getting some blood flow to low body. Today is going to be a doozy. Don't know if you looked at your notes or not, but I'm here to tell you it's going to be a doozy. Today's style you might be familiar with and you might not. That's the beauty of new people hopping in with us each month and all that good stuff. This is filthy 50 style, which means we are doing a lot of reps of each exercise. Just like it sounds, we are doing 50 reps to be exact. Butt kicks here. Okay, so lean a little bit forward. Do not lean back. Lean a little bit forward. Keep your core braced. Okay, breathe through the nose. Exhale out the mouth. So what this means for us is it's working a little bit of endurance of our athletic performance here. So you might need to take, you probably need to take your weights up a little bit. This is a really good workout for those of you who don't have super high weights actually and are usually feeling like, man, I could have done a lot more, but I couldn't have, I don't have any weights to go up with. We're gonna do leg swings. You can grab a wall or a chair or something for balance. Standing knee is soft. So like I said, just like it sounds, 50 reps of every exercise. The challenge here doing this with the recorded video is that I'm gonna wanna take breaks probably at different times than you're gonna wanna take breaks. Maybe some exercises you don't need to take any breaks. Maybe some you need a lot, okay? So feel it out, please pace yourself, and we'll kind of meet up at the end of the 50. The idea here is form over everything. Okay, leg swings to the front, standing knee soft. You can bend this top knee. We're just blowing it out here. So form first, okay? For example, our first exercise is a goblet squat. I care about your back not rounding. I care about your core being braced. Switch legs here, okay? Next thing we care about is speed and power. So I want you to record your overall time that this workout takes you. And it might be a little bit different back to butt kicks than mine is, okay? Especially without the demos. Maybe week one, this takes you 30 to 35 minutes. High knee pulls here. You can use your arms or not. But maybe the next week it takes you like 28 minutes, or say it took you 35, then it takes you 32, okay? So that's another way to gauge this. It's not all about going up in weight. Rest, grab water if you want it. It is about push. So all that being said, we have 5 exercises, 50 reps, kiss it goodbye onto the next exercise. So take breaks whenever you need to. I can't make that more clear. I wanna make that very clear for you, okay? You don't have to do all 50, then take a break. I might do that on some. I might take breaks though. I don't know. It depends on how my body feels today, okay? So all 50, then we'll meet up at the end of the set. Just keep going at your own pace. Take breaks. You can pause me if you want in between, or just catch me at the end when we all rest. Then we go on to the next exercise, okay? Banded goblet squats. So if you have that mini band, grab it. I'm going to use my medium. If you don't have a mini band, no big deal. Just do regular goblet squats. If you have it, it's going up above knees. That's adding a little bit of outer thigh, outer glute. We're going to go feet hip width or a little wider. Core braced hard like somebody's going to hit you. Don't suck it in. And then we're going to add even more to this by putting a weight here. If you're newer and this band is more than enough tension for you for 50 squats, stay with that week one, okay? Everybody's in different spots. Now, I usually am squatting like, I have a couple different variations here. I'll do 50 pounds for a lot of things, a lot of 12 reps, whatever. I'm kind of right now between thinking 35 or 25. I am going to start with 35, and I will probably need more breaks, or I might just go down to the 25. We'll see. So feet hip width are a little wider, core brace, shoulders relaxed. Whenever you're ready to start, you're sitting back in the heels, butt toward knees. On an inhale, you're exhaling up. So try not to go too far below knee level. I don't like going too far below parallel for most of us because most of us are rounding our back, so it's just safe to say butt to knees. The other challenge here is not losing count, so I try to count my tens in my head. That was the first 10. I want you to inhale down, exhale, push up through your heels, and squeeze your glutes. The next thing I want you to think about is don't overextend at the top. Please don't do that. Your lower back does not want you to do that. Yes. I already lost track. I don't know if this is 20 or 25, so I'm going to do five more, and then I'm going to take a break. Four, three, two. You know I always err on the side of doing more if I'm not sure. Okay, that was a for sure. At least 25. Take a little shake. Take it a breather. I'm going to try to go right into the next 25. Deep breaths in through the nose. Exhale them out. Keep going if you're going. Core brace form over everything else. Take break if you need it. Drop weight if you need it. Slow it down, but form first. Woo! Yes! We are warmed up. Yes, come on. Core bracing hard, you got this. Heart rate's up. Every time we're squatting, we're down to the last 10. We don't have to squat again. 9, 8, come on, through the heels. 7, push. I know, my back's getting fatigued too. 5, up, 4, up, 3, pull. So good. Good, big, huge rest. Huge rest. I know, back was helping us out. Breathe, walk it out, get water. I'm gonna leave the band on, so I'm gonna show you what's next. We are still taking our breathers. Banded hip thrust. That's why I have the bench. You can use a bench step or chair. I like to put the mat there because I'm a baby. And I don't like it to hurt my shoulder blades. So hip thrust. We set up getting our elbows off of the bench. Okay, elbows are free. Feet are hip width. Knees and ankles, they're not right in line with each other. Usually I have my feet a little farther out, but personal preference a little bit. So your starting position is glutes off the ground, elbows free. This is the hip thrust itself. As we pick the hips up, we exhale, look through the thighs, we inhale down. So we are pushing through the heels, squeeze glutes. So you can do it with just the band, or if you don't have the band, you can put a single dumbbell across your hips. It's the most comfortable way I think to do it. It's hard to fit two dumbbells there, but you could try to work with that as well. The sun's moving as I'm recording. Recording later in the day. I am not going to try to add a dumbbell. I'm just gonna do it with the band for week one. I know I gotta do 50. This is what I'm working with, okay? So then week two, I can either go to my heaviest band or I can add a weight. I've got room to go, but I'm shooting for 50. Just like I am right now. Okay, here we go. It is very important to look through the thighs, even though it sounds goofy, because if we're looking up, our back is going to arch. When you look through the thighs, it helps you tuck your pelvis, and you need to tuck your pelvis on this. Okay, elbows are free. Let's go. So breaks, whenever you need it. Good. Woo! These are actually really good for your core, too, especially those of us who are more freshly postpartum. This is a great exercise to get the core back in the game. Good. Now, you're gonna feel these a little bit in your low back, too. Low back is helping out a lot today. So if you even need a break just for low back, go ahead and take it. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. My feet were starting to go out too far. You saw me just zip them back in. That was 20. Good. Woo! Glutes on fire. I'm gonna try to not take a break here. Quads feeling it a little bit too because they're helping out in this. Oh. 2. 1 is to 30. Good. 20 more. Adjust something if you need to adjust. Take a little breather if you need to. Inhale, exhale. Don't stop pushing through the heels. This is really active. Look through the thighs. Come on. Up. Up. Whew. Use your breath. Final 10, and we don't have to do these again. Up. I know. You love it. I love it. love the results. Come on. Really strong glutes, strong low body. 3, 2, last one. You take nothing else away from today. It's going to be the fact that I cannot count, because I guarantee you I'm not doing 50 of any of these. It's got to be 55, 48. I would be shocked. So if you are watching this, like, you have literally never done 50. Yes, I believe it. That is something that I would do. So next up, as you take breaks, as you get water, as you walk around and will yourself to do the next bit of this workout, step ups are next. How this looks, you use a bench step or chair, put one foot on it. The higher it is, the harder it is, okay? Now a big pelvic tuck again. We don't want to be overarched. We want to draw the belly button toward our chin, and we want to stay a little bit lean forward. I always say this for lunges too. You don't want to be upright because you're gonna inevitably lean back. So take it in your core, not your low back. This foot is staying where it is. We're gonna push up through that heel, exhaling up, inhaling down slow and controlled. It's much easier to do these popping up, popping down. That's a little more cardio style. We're not doing that. We're working the low body, working the legs. Unfortunately, I had the terrible idea for us to do all 50 on one leg, all 50 on the other. It's going to be terrible. I wish right now I just was thinking about changing it to 25, 25, but I'm not. So 50 on one, 50 on the other. You know yourself, body weight might be the way to go. Maybe you're going to add weight to this. Maybe you're going to put it down halfway. The heart rate is going to go way up because it's basically like we're going up the stairs. I'm going to hold 10s in each hand, which normally I would do more than that. I don't even really want any weight doing all 50 on one leg, so we got what we got, okay? Take breaks whenever you need it. One foot on, slight lean forward. We go exhale up, so then it's down slow and controlled. So that back foot is really doing nothing. It's all about pushing through the front heel, and you're getting to mostly straight. What I don't want you to do is lock out that knee. That knee is still gonna stay soft at the top. Shoulders down away from ears. Arms are long. We're exhaling up, inhaling down. You will think of me, I am sure, when you go up the stairs tomorrow. Good, be like, I did this about 9 million times yesterday. Good, but stay in it for now. If you really want to, you guys, it's your workout. You could absolutely switch sides at halfway to give that side a break. The only reason I'm not doing that is because we are working the endurance, the athletic performance. So I'm gonna challenge it to stay on one side. But if you're dying and you only have so much time to do your workout, feel free to personalize. You always have the ability to do that, okay? Grip is light on those dumbbells if you have some. Breathing. I'm trying really hard to count on this one because I really don't want to do any extra. Whew. Good, so that's 20 by my count. Where are we feeling this? Definitely the foot that's on the bench in the quad, in the hamstring, in the glute. If you notice, there's a lot of hips going on here too. It's hips forward, hips back. Hips forward. Hips back. Stay strong in this. You got it. No big rocking. This is not cardio. That was halfway. What? I know. Wow. Don't even look at the time because it's probably going to be about 5 minutes of step ups on each leg. Woo! You got it. If this is hurting your knee at all, this is a lot of work on that knee joint, switch it to something else. Go ahead and do a wall sit. Hit some hamstring RDLs instead. Okay. Safety. Working where you work best. Again, we can always personalize things. Good. Up, up, up. If you ever have questions about that as you're in a workout, shoot me an email at the end of it. Ask what you can sub for something. Okay. I mean that. Exhale up. Inhale down. Oh, my heavenly day. Whew. It's good. It's really good. Would have been a shame if we did 25 on each leg. We'd already be done. That'd be terrible. Last 10 by my count. Oh, dig through that heel. Low controlled. If you flew through these and now you're just watching me do them thinking, I don't know why she's taking so long, I want you to slow it down next time, because it is harder if you slow it down. There's nothing that drives me more crazy than when someone tells me a workout was easy because they flew through it and or didn't use appropriate weight, okay? Woo! Good, I think I have one less, so that's what I'm gonna do. One more. Holy cow. Now I'm gonna have 5 minutes in heaven on the other side. Other foot up, slight lean forward. Exhaling up, inhaling up. See how nice and fresh this leg is. There's also a really long time to hold on to weights. So if you need to put them down, put them down. If you're still holding them, just make sure you have a nice light grip, not a death grip. You notice, ladies, I'm sure you do, how out of breath I am. Like I told you, our heart rate is totally up from these because it is just like we are going upstairs. Good, keep it up. Push through the heel and focus on those hips too. Hips and shoulders are square to the direction you're going. I have managed to already totally lose track. I think this is 10, but it feels like that was more. Maybe not. Oh. This is the grittiest it gets. In my opinion, this is the worst exercise of the list. And it was the most brutal because we had to do it all on one side and all on the other. So the really good news is we only have two exercises left after this, and we don't have to do them all on one side and all on the other, okay? We get to bang it out on both legs at the same time. So once you get through this absolute hill right now, it's gonna go downhill, I promise. Good, that was about 20, hopefully. Exhale up, inhale down. I know, it's fine, it's supposed to be hard. It is supposed to be uncomfortable. A lot of us were doing workouts that were too easy before and we saw no change in our bodies. So why waste our time? Obviously, some movement is better than no movement, but if you want to see change in your body, if you want to stay strong, maybe even get stronger, if you want to stay lean or get leaner, you've got to up level. Okay, so it's gonna be uncomfortable. It should be uncomfortable. We're at about 20 left. Holy cow. Push through the heel on that exhale. I know. Woo! That quad could not be more on fire. Wow. You got this. 15. And I'm not gonna ask you to step up again today. Up. And down. Woo! Come on, find that little spunk. Find that fire. Make it through the next 11 reps. Whatever you have to do, growl, swear, I don't care. Unless your kids are working out with you. Hi, kids. Woo! That's why I don't, but you can. 7 more. Key change to get us there. Thank you, T-Pain. Up. Oh, hips. Come on, 4. Up. Bring it home. 3. Woo, 2. Let's go. Up, up, up. 1 more time. Set it off. Oh, my word. Good job. I know. I'm sorry. I'm sorry I did that to us. But like I said, it's got to be uncomfortable. If I had let us all take the option to go down to 25, we would have done it because we want to do what's easy. Humans want to do what's easy. But you made it, and I'm proud of you. Now, half surrenders are next. If you have the option to put a band right around knee level with an anchor point, that's what I want you to do, and I'm going to show you this one first. You're going to put your body in it. You're going to put that band in your low hips, across from your glutes, not up at your waist. You're gonna come up where you have tension. You're gonna sit back on your heels and you're gonna push through. That is it, that's the whole exercise. Glutes on fire, quads on fire is gonna be fantastic. If you can't anchor, no worries. You're not gonna use a band, which actually this turned out to be a little high for me. You want it in line with your glutes, okay? So you can't anchor anything, I get it. That's a limitation for some people. You're gonna do the same exercise, going back, coming forward. Instead, add a weight to your chest. It's a little bit different, the tension point's a little different. Still a great exercise, okay? So, deep breaths, water if you want it. Here we go, it's great. We don't have to step up anymore. Anything's better than that, right? So give yourself some tension, core brace. We sit, back in the heels, bring it forward. Just like I talked about with the squats, we do not want to overthrust and put in our backs. Stop right here. Inhale, exhale. Hold. Yep. Come on. Back up. This is a perfect beat to follow. And remember, ladies, this is your workout. You can take breaks anytime. I just would not advise going faster than this beat. This is a good beat, or slower if you need it. That's 15. Push, good. Make sure you have enough tension on that band. If you need to go farther away, do it. I think that's 20. Up, good. So knees are hip width or a little wider. Mine keeps scooting wider, so I keep bringing them back into hip width. Make sure that band stays low hip. Yup. Come on. It's all about the hip action on this one too. Hip hinge back, bring it forward. It looks like nothing. They're killer, I love it. Come on. We are so close. I'm gonna try to go a little farther out for the last 20. Gonna regret it. Here we go, hips back. Hips, oh yeah, it's a lot more glutes. Wow, good. We lost the beat. It's okay. I'm slowing off the beat anyways. I'm just trying to power through these last 14. Hips back, hips up. Ah, come on. Yes, nine. Push. It's really hard to be excited for all 50 reps, but we got it. Be excited that we don't have to do another round, you know? That's the nice part about not having supersets or circuits. You do it once and you're done, one and done, three. The price of admission is just 50 reps, that's all. But it's one and done, good. Get out of it, good job. Okay, lastly, if you have that mini band, put it right above your knees. I'm gonna show you some options. If you don't have the mini band, you can do this with just your body weight. Pop squats, it is a little bit of intensity on the knees. It's a low intensity, but still. We're dropping into a squat. We're bringing it back in, feet hip width. Don't let the feet touch. So you get a little bit of impact, okay? This is not as much impact as doing like a jump squat. I don't do those. That's too much impact on the knees. I don't do jumping lunges. This is minimal impact, but there is still impact. So if you want zero impact, you're doing sidestepping squats. If you're doing that, absolutely count. You can count like each one. One, two, three, four, so we can all try to end together, okay? This is it, we're going out on this. 50 pop squats or sidestepping squats. Bring the core in and brace it. Don't lean back. We go, inhale, exhale. I am surely counting these. Because anything that has a slight cardio twinge, I am not trying to do more of. Here we go. What I don't want you to do, ladies, is round out your back. Your chest stays proud. Your back stays flat. I already lost count because I talked to you. I think that was 10. Down, down, yes. Good. Breaks anytime we need it. That's 15. Woo! Yes. 8, 7 is to halfway. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, I'm gonna take a breather here. Holy cow, quads on fire, a little out of breath, it's good. Deep breath in through the nose, Exhale out the mouth. Last one. Down, up. Come on. Yes. Push it out. Come on. Oh, final 10. 10. 9 in the heels. Dip back. 6. 5. Come on. 3. 2. Get out. Holy cow, ladies. Breathe in through the nose. Exhale, let it go. I am so proud of you. Now, heart rate just got up. Right to take us to the finish. So walk it out. Take some deep breaths. In through the nose. Exhale, let it go. Very, very well done. Once your heart rate has come down a little bit, we can stretch low body. But I want you to wait till you can at least talk, unlike me right now. So while you need the heart rate to come down, keep the feet moving. Step touch. March in place. Get some deep breaths in through the nose. Exhale, let it go. I like to stretch the muscles that we just worked. So standing knee soft. Quad stretch. You can lean a little bit forward. Beautiful. Switch sides. Those beautiful glutes that did 50 hip thrusts. Cross that ankle over the opposite knee. Sit back. Gently, you can open into that knee. Keeping chest up. Breathe. Yes. Don't you feel accomplished? Woo, first workout, baby, of the month, of the week. You're going in order. And feel free to mix up the order. Hamstring stretch. Hands to your bent leg. And we sit back. Like I mentioned a couple times in this workout, it's a general group. We're all doing this together. We're following the monthly focus so that we know we're getting good programming every month that's serving a different purpose to keep us well-rounded. Elbows to knees. Keep your knees bent. Grab your elbows. Let your head go and stay here for 5 breaths. I will tell you when we come up so you don't have to stare at the screen. So that is the idea in this group, ladies, that we don't always do the exact same kind of workout, the exact same focus, always fat loss or always strength building or always whatever. We follow a year program to make sure we're hitting balance, coordination, power, etc. But you can always still personalize it, okay? Deep breaths in through the nose. Exhale them out. If you have some equipment you want to incorporate that you're not sure how, that's another thing we could talk about on a coaching call or in an email. Super slow roll up, like a barbell. You could toss that in the hip thrust. There are tons of options. Feet together, deep breath in through the nose. Exhale, let it go. Very, very nice job. You will see no more filthy 50s from me this month. So I will see you next workout. Get some water, get some protein. Have a good rest of your day.